I am Noah, and this is my mom, Carrie. And she used to go here. She might cry because she's a weirdo.
Hi, everyone. I'm Carrie. I did actually used to go here. It seemed like a million years ago, but it was like 18 years ago. So this is really special, and I really just want to thank you all for having us. Again, my name is Carrie, and my son, Noah, has stage 4 Wilms. There's a couple different categories that it falls under. There's favorable histology and unfavorable histology. Thankfully, he has the favorable histology. So scientifically, it looks really nice and pretty underneath the microscope, and it's easier to treat, so that's a bonus. Kind of a downer is he got genetic testing done, and it's positive. So there's a higher risk for relapse. So they had to change up his protocol to be more aggressive and really attack cancer cells. To kind of start, Noah was a very seemingly healthy child. He was super active. He practiced karate year-round, seasonal soccer, basketball, swimming, and he is very well known by his friends and family for dancing. He loves breakdancing. Commercials, songs, anything, he's dancing, and he still does it, so he's pretty special. To start it all off, he started a new school last September, 2012, and I was getting on average 1 to 2 phone calls a week at work saying that he wasn't feeling well. I would go to pick him up, and sometimes he would still be not feeling well, and sometimes you know, it would be like a light switch and he'd be okay. So we kind of brushed it off as kind of new school nerves until he started getting this extreme pain in the middle of the night. He would come running out of his room. Yeah, do you want to tell them?
The pain felt like I fell off my bed on the side of the table.
Yeah, it was sore. He'd come running out of his room in this awful high-pitched scream, cupping the right side of his ribs, and so we realized this was obviously something that you can't fake. This wasn't new school nerves anymore. So as that got progressively worse, we noticed it for about 2 weeks. We finally brought him into a walk-in clinic, and they issued some testing, so some chest x-ray and blood testing and ultrasounds. That was on a Monday. On the Thursday, we were able to go in and do the ultrasound, and by Thursday afternoon, which was October 18th of 2012, we received a phone call from the doctors letting us know what they had found on the ultrasound. And they had found quite a large tumor on his right kidney. There was no protrusion from his body at all because it was literally tucked under his ribs, so there was no visible way to really kind of see such a big mass. They said it was indicative of something called Wilms tumor, which is a cancer of the kidney that grows mainly in children. And a lot of times it's not found until the mass is quite large. So since that day until now, our lives have moved fairly quick. Thanks to McMaster Children's Hospital and Jervinsky. They kind of swept us under their wing, and we kind of went on this really fast roller coaster of treatment. So the following week consisted of confirmation scans and exams, confirming the findings. And a lot of tests and scans and meetings with doctors and a ton of medical information was given to us. And as a parent, it was mind-blowing to see how fast things were happening. And for Noah, I think it was pretty scary for all of this to start happening, and he didn't know why and when and how and, you know, what was next. So we did our best to really kind of inform him as much as he could really, you know, take in as a 7-year-old. 6 days later, he underwent a major surgery to take the tumor and his right kidney. Thankfully, they were able to take the tumor. There was a chance that they would go in and it would be attached to a lot of major organs and they wouldn't be able to take it. So thankfully, they were able to take it. The mass, I think, was said to be like a 12 by 10 centimeter mass or something. And if you can see, he's a pretty tiny guy over here, so it was quite a large mass. So unfortunately, by the time we had found the cancer, it had already spread to his lungs and his abdomen, making it a stage 4 cancer. So the treatment plan that he's on requires both radiation and chemotherapy, and he received 9 cycles consistently each day
And I also couldn't walk.
Oh yeah, he couldn't walk after the surgery. It took quite a while to recover from it, but he did very well. And he received 9 cycles of radiation on his abdomen in November of 2012 when his chemotherapy started, and 8 cycles of radiation on his lungs in January of this year. His chemotherapy is a combination of 5 different drugs that he gets weekly, if not biweekly. And again, this all started the day after his 8th birthday, last year in November. So the side effect, it'll last for about 31 weeks. So without any delays, June 10th will be his last chemotherapy day. So it'll be quite a celebration for us. The side effects of which are quite intense. Chemotherapy medicine acts in a way that it either destroys the cells or it stops the cells from growing. Having said that, it damages the healthy cells as well. So all of the fast-growing cells in your mouth, your hair, or your nails, all of those get affected, along with the fast-growing cancer cells. So Noah experiences a lot of nausea and vomiting, loss of appetite, weight loss. He gets a bone pain, which he just ended up having, and we didn't know if he'd be able to come up on stage, but thankfully it's passed. It's a pain in the bones, so it's not something that you can necessarily massage out. So he also gets mouth sores, obviously hair loss, and a lowered immune system, and an extreme lack of energy. Sometimes he also gets daily injections after his inpatient chemo. It stimulates the bone marrow to pretty much heighten his immunity because the chemotherapy wipes it out. So those are all the facts of cancer, and you know the fact is cancer sucks. The reality of cancer is pretty ugly. He spent his 8th birthday, Halloween, Christmas, Easter, and countless weekends in the hospital. An April Fool's Day. I mean, who wants to miss April Fool's Day? So as a parent, seeing the nurses for the first time kind of walk into his hospital room with complete hazardous material gear on, shields over their eyes, masks over their mouth, not an inch of skin showing, gloves, gowns, and they come in with this nice, huge, see-through bag of a syringe, and it's got all the toxic substance, you know, labels written all over it. And here they are to come administer it to my son. So it's not fair. It doesn't seem fair. The isolation factor involved in cancer treatment has been hard for him and all of us to kind of deal with, since his immunity is most often greatly compromised. He can't be around large crowds or anyone that is sick. He's had to stay home a lot because of this, and basically he's missed his third grade. So he will do that again. His school has been amazing with helping, sending his teacher home to do some schoolwork with him. But it's so hard when you don't have energy to do basic things. To then try and focus on schoolwork is very hard for him. So. This young man has had to endure a lot of things most kids his age will never see. And thankfully, he has a great support system. No child, teenager, adult, or senior citizen should have to go through this. Amazingly, he has a very positive outlook on life and has grown so much over the past 6 months that I can't wait to see the person that he becomes in the future. So, not every day is good. I'm not crying yet. You should have bet. You probably would have won. Not every day is good, but we try our best to find the good part of every day. We try to sit at night and think of the good things and kind of end our day with that, because there's so much crap he's got to go through in a day. I think as an adult, I would probably crumble in his position. So I admire him. He's definitely my hero. There are so many cancers out there, and so many types, so many stages, so many treatment plans, and yet so many without a cure. So what I want you guys all to kind of take away from this is, you know, the support you provide, the strength you show, and the positive force that you bring in all of your fundraising efforts, it all really does help. You know, we need to find more cures for this awful, awful disease. So with that, I will pass the mic over to Noah to answer some questions that I think are relevant.
What is it like to have that pain in your side before the doctors found cancer?
It felt like a really sharp pain, like something was going through your body.
What is the worst part of having cancer?
Worst part of having cancer is that I don't get to play with my friends or do anything. I just sit in the hospital bed.
What is the best part of having cancer?
Missing school.
What are some of the things you want to do when you become healthy again?
When I'm healthy, I'm going to have like a birthday, you know, that it's not my birthday, and play laser tag.
What's this necklace you have
me wearing? It's my bravery necklace that I got from the hospital. It's all the beads that, like, the small beads are the ones that, like, all my pokes, like, needles, and the green bead with the guy with the green face, who looks like an old freak, and it means you puked, and I got two of those, and, huh?
So I thought you guys could give it up one more time for Carrie Noah.